Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to be looking at the electrical system on our 2007 Honda TRX400 EX. Specifically, we're going to start looking at the battery and the charging system. It's a fairly simple system. There's basically three different parts that you want to look at. The battery itself, your regulator rectifier, and then behind this cover, there's going to be a stator. So what we're going to do is take measurements for each part of the system and make sure they're within spec. So let me grab the meters we're going to use, which is going to be a snap-on meter. You want to make sure that your whatever meter you use has what they call a diode function, because we're going to be looking inside the regulator rectifier to make sure that that full circuit rectification is working correctly. Other thing we're going to use is just a battery tester, and that'll tell us the condition of our battery. So let's get started. All right, guys, one of the first things we need to do is go ahead and take just a static reading of the battery voltage at rest with the vehicle shut off. We just want to see where it's sitting right now. So we want to set our meter, so just volts DC, which is two lines straight across. And she's reading about 12.2. Well, I know it's a 12-volt battery, but that's not really where we want to be. A fully charged battery, we want closer to 12.8, maybe even 13 volts. It will start the machine, so what I want to do is go ahead and start it up and see what type of charging voltage we're getting out of it. So, what we want it to get to is a little over 14. It's coming on up. And even at idle, 14.2, that's about where we would want it. All right, so far the charging system, it seems to be doing what it's supposed to be doing. I'm a little suspect of this battery. So what we want to do next is put an actual battery tester on it that is battery specific. So we're gonna disconnect the leads, go into the machine, and get it hooked up to this tester, and take a reading and see where we stand. So let's go ahead and get this one completely disconnected from the machine. Go ahead and do your negative side first, and pop off your positive. So it's reading about the same as the voltammeter, about 12.1, 12.18, somewhere in there. So what we want to do is select which model battery it is, YTX9-BS, and go ahead and let it go through a full test. All right, it's telling me I need to replace the battery because its state of health is 0%. Charge, about 40%. So yeah, it'll continue to start the machine, but for how many more times? Probably not many. The service life of this battery is done. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove it from the machine, gonna head to the stock room, pick up a new one, show you how to get it serviced, get it charged up, and then we'll get it installed and see where we end up. All right, guys, I just went to the stock room to pick up the battery we're going to need for this. It is a battery made by Yuasa, and the exact model number is a YTX9-BS. And the real trick with this one, it is what they call a dry glass mat. So there's actually mat inside of this battery casing. And to that, you add the electrolyte. It'll go in and fill in all those voids and then charge the plates inside of there. Now the real trick with this battery is, yes, Partzilla.com can sell you the battery, but we can't ship the electrolyte. So if you do decide to buy a battery from us, you'll have to pick up your electrolyte somewhere locally. Other thing you're going to need is a charger. Now chances are you don't have a $500 Christie charger sitting in your garage, but what you can do is just get something as simple as a battery tender or one of these little automatic chargers from UASA. These can charge it from a starting point. And the good part about these is you can leave it attached to your vehicle in the off season and it'll take care of the battery, make sure it's up to charge, you know, when you're not using it. Because the last thing you want to do is let the battery go dead, get flat, and then it sulfates, and then you've just wasted a battery. All right, the first thing we need to do is go ahead and pull this seal, take this cap off the electrolyte, and just punch it straight down on the battery. All right, it'll take about 10 minutes for the electrolyte to go into the battery. Then you want to let it sit for about 20 to 30 minutes so it really gets absorbed into that mat. And once that is that time has passed, we can go ahead and hook it up to the charger and charge it for about an hour. And that should get us ready to go back on the machine. So I'll be back in a few minutes once she gets through filling up. All right, guys, we've had the electrolyte in the battery for about 30 minutes now. So it should be all absorbed into that glass mat. All we need to do now is go and connect it to our charger. On this particular charger, I need to go ahead and set the amperage that's going to be fed into it, 5.5 to 9. It's going to charge for about an hour, and off she goes. Now granted, this big machine can get it done in about an hour. If you're using a small battery tender like one of these two, it's going to take a little bit longer, so be prepared to wait in between 3 and 4 hours for one of these two to get the job done. So I'm going to let this charge, then we'll get the cap put back on it and get it reinstalled in the machine. So I'll see you in about an hour. All right, let's go ahead and disconnect from the charger and let's get our cap back, or get our cap on, period. And set our meter, DC volts, go ahead and connect up. Let's see where we ended up. Should be around 13 volts. Yep, 13.01. Let me flip this around and I'll let you take a peek at it. To getting the battery out, it's only held in by this one bracket. You've got a 10 millimeter down at the bottom, and then there's one up at the top, kind of hidden under the wiring harness, right there. And the bracket just pulls away. From there, the whole battery slides out, and then it'll actually come straight out of its case, just like that. All right, we've got our battery sealed up and ready to go. Just need to go ahead and pop her in her case, slide her in there. But before I hook it up to the machine, let's test it one more time and see what its health is. So get those connected. Run our test one more time. And that's what we want. 100% health, or very close to it. Charged all the way. All right, she is tested out exactly like we want. What I'm gonna do now is go and connect it back up, positive first, then the negative, then put the strap that holds it in place on the side. And what I wanna go ahead and look into after that is, what if the battery tested out all right? I mean, what would you need to look for if it wasn't charging properly? So we're going to look at the rectifier as well as the stator. So, but let's first get it connected back up, and then I'm going to show you which wires to look at on each one of those pieces to see if they're functioning as they should. All right? All right, this is really a very simple charging system. Basically, what you have is just a single phase output on your stator, and it goes back to your regulator rectifier, which converts it into 12 volts DC, or a little bit more than that actually, but DC voltage from AC voltage, which charges your battery. All right, if the battery checked out like it was supposed to, and you still weren't getting charged, what we need to check first is the output of the stator voltage. And what that actually is going to be AC voltage. So the way you can get to it is using just a pair of these little, what they call back probes. And they actually go in between the rubber insulator and the wire itself. Now don't pierce the coating or the covering of the wire, because we just want to put it in between the rubber and the wire itself. Get a couple of our leads. Polarity isn't going to be in play here because it's AC voltage that we're measuring. Get that clamped in. All right, we're going to set the meter to AC volts. We're going to start it up. All right, so that's telling us that we are getting AC voltage, which we already knew. But if that was, you know, 2 or 3 volts, then you would know that you probably have an issue with the stator itself. Other than that, we can check the diodes on the inside of the regulator rectifier. And how you do that, switch it over to diode mode. What you're going to do is forward and reverse bias the diodes. All right, now once you get your leads in there and those back probes stuck in, they're going to sit about right here. They're making contact. And what you were looking for is a forward bias of the diode going from that yellow wire over to the red. And it's reading 0.499, which is basically 0.5 volts, and that's what the forward bias is on a diode. Check your pink wire, and you should get about the same reading. Right there. So that tells me that the diodes, inside the rectifier are good. We already looked at the output voltage in AC, and it was good as well, but we pretty much expected that. But if your diodes read like they're supposed to and the voltage is off up front, then that'll pretty much tell you you're going to need to open up that case, that cover, and take a look at your stator. All right, with all the readings checking out, this one's pretty much ready to go. But listen, as you're making your measurements and things don't match up like they're supposed to, if you need a rectifier or the stator or one of those chargers that I showed you earlier, you know, come see us at Partzilla.com. And if you have any other questions, just leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to answer them. So until then, we'll see you next time.